context and meaning to all the events that follow this evening. You know, the children of Warrington, they are going to narrate the story of Diwali. And I would like to begin by introducing each one of them on the stage. Angel, and please encourage them with a round of applause as they come here. Sishant, Ahana, Misha, Kapya, Charvi, Girija, Akshar. I will now hand it over to Angel to start narrating the story of Diwali for all of us.
Hello everyone, and welcome to this year's Diwali celebration in Warrington. Do you know why we celebrate Diwali every year?
Yes, I know. We celebrate it so we can have lots of fun. Delicious food, sweets and firecrackers. We also like beers in our home.
And we meet friends and related.
Yes, all of it is true, but there's a very interesting story of why we celebrate Diwali. The story of Lord Ram and the demon king Ravana.
I love listening to stories, can't wait, let's begin.
Thousands of years ago in the city of Ayodhya in India, there was a wise and good king named Dashrath. He ruled with his three queens, Kaushalya, Kaikeyi and Sumitra. Dashrath had four sons, Ram, Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughan.
The eldest prince Ram and his beautiful wife Sita lived happily along with his other prince brothers and their wives.
One of King Dashrath's wife Kaikeyi was jealous of Ram and demanded that he be exiled to the forest for 14 years so that her son Bharat gets to be made the king.
As Dashrath had promised Kaikeyi to fulfill any wish of her, the helpless king exiled Ram to the forest. Ram set off on foot with his wife Sita and his younger brother Lakshman. Years later, through the exile, a demoness called Surpanaka saw Ram and fell for his looks. She asked Ram to marry her. Ram refused and asked her to go to Lakshman instead.
But Lakshman also refused. Then Surpanaka showed her true form. Then Lakshman cut off her nose and her ears.
Surpanaka went find her big brother Ravan, the king of Lanka, really furious and wanted revenge. With the help of another demon who took the form of a golden deer, Ravan distracted Ram and Lakshman to kidnap Sita.
As soon as they returned, they realized something bad had happened because Sita was missing. They immediately rushed to find her.
On their way, they came across an army of monkeys and bears who agreed to help them. Among them was Hanuman, a devotee of Ram.
Now Hanuman was no ordinary monkey. He could fly over mountains, gain size at will, and had superhuman strength.
Hanuman had the power to leap across oceans in a single strike to prove he was helping Ram. Hanuman took Ram. Hanuman found Sita in prison in one of Ravan's beautiful gardens in Lanka.
At first, Sita did not believe Hanuman, thinking that he was a demon. Then Hanuman took Ram's ring to prove it was sent by Ram to help.
Sita was really happy, but Ravan got Hanuman and put his tail on fire.
Hanuman used his tail to set the castle of Ravan on fire and he escaped.
Hanuman returned to Ram with Sita's whirlabouts and the armies of monkeys, bears and men marched to for Lanka.
A great battle started between the two mighty armies. Ram's soldiers managed to kill all the demons except one, Ravan. The battle was now between Ram and Ravan. Ram gave Ravan one last chance to apologize and return Sita.
Ravan instead rained down weapons on him. Ram fought back, but despite all his efforts, nothing seemed to kill Ravan.
Ravan's brother Vibhishan wasn't happy with the evil deeds of Ravan and was willing to help Ram. Vibhishan told Ram that Ravan's weakest point was in navel and he could have died if he was attacked there.
Using an arrow given to him by the gods, Ram shot Ravan in his navel and killed him instantly.
Ram and his love Sita were finally reunited.
After 14 years of exile, Ram, Lakshman and Sita returned to Ayodhya and found the entire city waiting for them.
The streets were decorated with flowers and lamps and there was happiness everywhere.
Now I know why we celebrate Diwali.
Yes, just like the city of Ayodhya, we celebrate Diwali in the months of October or November to celebrate Ram and Sita's homecoming and the victory of good over evil.
And you know what? Apart from the celebration, we clean up and decorate our homes with different coloured lanterns and things.
Yes, my mum says keeping our homes neat and clean attracts the attention of God and brings prosperity.
That's a great story with lots of drama. I enjoyed it.
Yes, me too. And it has very useful lessons as well.
I must say sweets and firecrackers are still my favourite.
Hope you all enjoyed the story of Diwali. Yay.
Thank you. Thanks a lot to the children. I would also like to thank all the moms who have really, you know, spent a lot of effort in preparing them.